Yes, it was merely centered around a bit of foolishness. Donovan, who began his recording career as a one-man skiffle band and did Keep On Truckin' It Mom on his very first album called Catch the Wind, and the Purple Gang, one of the very last of the skiffle bands over in England, Purple Gang doing Kiss Me Goodnight, Sally Green, and Steve Miller, who just incorporates everything into his music, but mostly that... I'll listen to that. You're listening to WBCN in Boston, that bebop radio station.
Everybody wants to know what I sing of.
The easiest thing in the world is making a commercial for a new B.B. King album. What makes this a particular pleasure? Well, the production on this album allows you to hear B.B. King's voice and guitar crystal clear, and the stereo separation is perfect, the mix is just right. In other words, you don't have to take B.B. King's guitar for granted. You can hear why every young guitarist would trade his soul for just one of B.B.'s hands. The new B.B. King album was recorded live at the Village Gate and the Hip Factory, so you get a double luxury, the fine sound of the studio and the excitement of a live performance. So when people say B.B. is the greatest, know they're right. Get B.B. King live and well, now available on ABC Bluesway.
It's been sort of a womp-bomp afternoon this afternoon so far. I haven't felt so good in a long time, which is why I generally am keeping my mouth shut this afternoon, because I want to listen to music, and I know you do too. Paul Williams will be telling us about the sort of things that have been going on up in Montreal. I can give you just a little quick preview. It has to do with some songs that he and Dr. Jim Leary and John and Yoko and some of their friends were rapping and singing about up in Montreal. And Paul Williams will be Dr. Timothy Leary's campaign manager. And Timothy Leary's, he'll be running for governor of California. Paul Williams will be his campaign manager. So we'll be talking with him a little bit later. What we were listening to were some Kerner things, the Love Bug, and then the Greenbrier Boys with their Love Bug, and then Mandala with Loveitis. They have an album out called Soul Crusades, about 6 months, 9 months old, and then Traffic with their Medicated Goo. And we're going back to Traffic with Feeling Good. Let me just go Brian Auger and the Trinity with The Thing From Here, Let the Sun Shine In and The Flesh Weakens. If you detect a note of sadness in the voice of Charles Laquidara over the last couple of months, it's because Julie Driscoll didn't want to go cruising up and down Washington Street in the back of his Chevrolet. There's something really special about Delaney and Bonnie. I go through that through the person of Bonnie herself. It has something to do with the joy that they have in doing what they're doing. I mean, it's a whole thing about how they really love doing what they're doing and will sing. They just love to. We'll be running the gamut of different things this afternoon on WBCN here in Boston.
Much, sir. The final take, Charles Laquidara, one take Chucky.
Out of sight.
If we tried to tell you about a new group called
wait,
the Sir...
Wait,
you mother...
You gotta give it a... You'll never get in there. Give it a moment. Quiet, please.
If we tried to tell you about a new group called the Serfs, you would immediately flash on bikinis, monsters, and a net, right? Well, try spelling it S-E-R-F-S and flash on this. The Serfs on Capitol Records. The Serfs combining rock with jazz and chugle. The Serfs on Capitol, available at Briggs & Briggs, Minuteman, Harvard Coop, New England Music City, and Jordan's.
The Serfs are appearing Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at the Boston Tea Party.
You can get your tickets for that at New Directions, at Cracker Jack's, at George's Folly, and down at Headquarters East. This is WBCN in Boston. We were listening to a group called East of Eden. It's an English group which records for Durham. They have an album called Mercator Projected. And we listen to In the Stable of the Sphinx. This is Bebop Radio, WBCN in Boston.
In Boston,
it's about 3:30. And Paul Williams has dropped by this afternoon. We slip over to that one over there. Try that.
Let's see. Patty.
Say, there. Do it again.
Hello.
Okay.
Does it work?
Yeah, Paul Williams was, had an unusual privilege to go up to Montreal and to talk with John Lennon and Yoko Ono and to sing some songs with them. How does it happen that you get to go up and go into their hotel up there and to fool around with John Lennon?
Well, I called up Derek and said, Patty, we've been thinking of coming up and seeing you. And he said, great, when are you coming? I've been traveling as a campaign manager, I'm sure there'll be others, for Timothy and Rosemary Leary. And Tim's running for governor in the state of California. And on a plane, coming from Miami to New York, we read that John and Yoko are in Canada. We decided that would be the next stop.
So were you traveling with Timothy Leary at that time?
Yeah, we've been traveling for about a week.
Oh, I see. So you went up together.
Yeah.
It was Timothy Leary, yourself, and
his old lady, Rosemary.
Okay, how stands that campaign?
Well, we're doing fine, man. It's getting better every day. We just started about 10 days ago.
And when did he decide to do that?
Well, after the Supreme Court threw out the federal marijuana laws. Yeah. You know, there aren't any federal laws against marijuana anymore.
Yeah.
Just state laws.
Because
that was on my birthday, so after they threw that out, they decided governor was the next natural move.
So it was a decision over one day.
Well, I don't know. I imagine you've been thinking about it for some time, but you know, I haven't asked him about it.
Has he had press conferences and things yet?
Yeah, we did several things. We did a press conference in New York. We were kind of hurried, which was unnecessary because we rushed out to get a plane that was at the wrong airport. So the press conference in New York didn't go as well as it might have. They also had one in Los Angeles and one in San Francisco. But it's like, you know, it's going to be one continuous press conference. I mean, the thing is that Leary has always, you know, done a lot of talking anyway. I mean, he likes to talk. He likes to, you know, give lectures and that sort of thing. And this just gives him another platform.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, running, you know, another opportunity to make people happy by letting them know that they're divine.
Has he made any policy statements as of yet?
Oh yeah, we got a lot of plans.
Describe
I'm not
the
saying
platform.
They're not subject to change. Well, basically, Sue.
They're not subject to change.
No, they are subject to change. Oh. I say that I'm not saying this is how it's going to be.
Okay.
This is what we're thinking right now. For one thing, the campaign is not aimed at the kids. It's aimed at the uptight middle class and right wing voters, because you know, the kids are happy already. The only thing we can do for the kids is to keep the state and the uptight people off their backs, right? They've got it under control. For one thing, there's going to be, marijuana will be legalized. There'll be a $1,000 user's tax, you know, for anyone who can pay it. In fact, we'll be taxing all pleasures, and people who don't have any pleasures we'll get tax rebates, you know, and get and we'll get triple police salaries, right?
I was thinking of a voting system whereby your vote would be in proportion to the dues that you pay to the particular government organization that you're within.
Yeah, right. Well, it's like, you know, I mean, no matter how you divide up the scene, you've got to admit that we're a lot happier than most of those people out there who are, you know, upset about all these things and voting for Ronald Reagan and freaking out. And the best thing we can possibly do is to make them happy, and we won't have any more problems. Their situation will be improved, they'll have better kids, and things will keep going upward.
What sort of things would he do to make people happier? What are the...
Is there a
five-year plan?
No, we haven't got it worked out like down to economic specifics, but
mm-hmm.
The idea is like, we'll give him money for one thing. I mean, you know, tax rebates for not... There'll be taxes on grass and on alcohol and anything that's fun. And then the people who don't have any fun, see, will get money back. And we're going to get the state out of the education business. That'll solve all their problems about, you know, riots and state funds going for these lousy kids and so on.
So schools would all be private?
Well, whatever. You know, if teachers and kids want to get together and have schools, they can do it. You know, they can even have the buildings that are there, but there's not going to be any more state-supported education. I don't, you know, I think that would make all of us happier, right? It's just let the people who want to keep the University of California open do it, but it won't be the University of California. It'll just be, you know, a party for those people who want to be involved in it.
So the schools would become an independent organization, something like it. You could subcontract out your schools.
I don't know what they become. They become whatever they wanted to become. if I personally I'd be interested in what schools become, because I don't think higher education has any meaning. It's good when you're young, like around 4 or 5, to be able to get together with other kids. And, you know, you need some way to do that. I don't think that schools the way they are now are the answer, but some sort of communal get-together so the kids can examine each other's heads instead of having to listen to adults all the time, because the adults just tell them nonsense. They can work things out with each other. By the time you get to be about, you know, 14 or 20, I don't see too much need for the formal. And we ended up singing a song, which is probably going to be the next Beatles single or John and Yoko single, called Give Peace a Chance. And the night after we made this tape, we were just fooling around. We all recorded it together.
Mm-hmm.
John had Capitol bring in that 4-track equipment from Toronto. And we just recorded track after track, singing, doing harmonies and stuff. You know, lots of people. I mean, everybody was around.
Mm-hmm.
Tommy Smothers playing guitar. 30 people on different parts of this song.
Let's try to do that, and I'll say a little prayer and hope that the next thing you'll hear will be part of that recording.
Well, I put it in a book, you know.
There it is.
Information retrieval.
Let me just get it together. You have a good life? You can join in the chorus, which is just give you a...
Everybody's talking about faggots and jaggots and flaggots and jaggots and maggots and flaggots 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 and flaggots. Everybody's talking about ministers, 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 canisters, bishops, bishops, rabbis, rabbis, bye-bye, goodbye. Yeah, all we are saying is give peace a chance. All we are saying is give peace a chance.
Yeah, all right.
Everybody's talking about revolution, evolution, masturbation, hydrate, regulate, imitate, meditate, congratulate, so far. All we are saying is give me a chance.
Yeah.
All we are saying is give me a chance.
Yeah.
Keep going.
You're listening to WBCN in Boston. It's about 4 o'clock, and that was done by, let's do it again, it was John Lennon, Yoko.
Yeah, John Lennon's a Libra, Yoko is an Aquarius, Timothy Leary is a Libra, and his wife is a Taurus, and I'm a Taurus.
And that will likely to become a campaign song for Dr. Leary.
Yeah, we'll use it as a campaign song for the summer.
Okay, Who is Dr. Leary running against? Because I think that I should say that certainly if campaign...
Or Jesse Unruh will want to come up here.
Ronald Reagan and who?
Well, Jesse Unruh will probably be the Democratic candidate. We've got a year and a half.
We're
not running against anybody.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like, the idea is to turn on the state as much as possible, and if things are rolling enough by next June when there's a primary, Tim won't have to run at all, you know. Unruh and Reagan will join our party. If that doesn't happen, then it may be necessary to go through the karmic duty of actually running and getting elected and becoming governor and that whole trip.
And paying dues.
Yeah, well, it won't be bad. I mean, we're not going to do anything just for fun.
It would certainly bring in a whole different set of issues.
Well, yeah,
into the political arena.
Myself. I'm sure other people will be raising it.
All right, well, let's do...
Yeah, there's more music on.
Okay, well, we'll have to find that someplace on the tape.
Let it keep playing and get back to it pretty soon.
Well, let's see what it's doing right now. Let's see. Oh, yeah, here it is. Lucky for us. There it is.
So we're just going to bring in a four-track machine here and get whoever's in the room to record it and just stick it out, John, Yoko, and whoever. So we've got this old rabbi, the 70-year-old one, we get him, because he told us he's going to make pop radios, you know, for teens. So we told him to go naked on the cover and make a promo film in black leather, you know, 70-year-old.
Well, when we're at Atlanta or something, see, we'll just play this tape in the microphone, you know.
we'll have thousands and thousands of kids singing with this song.
Great. Well, if we get out, you'll get out. We'll get it out, you know.
Yeah, sure.
I just want to build up the chorus a bit so they get the picture more. You know,
yeah, right.
Record it. Because there's just no time to get down to all our recording jazz and getting all the boys and have you got the chords right. Just get it out.
You're listening to WBCN in Boston, that ticking in the background. It's Paul Williams' tape recorder. It sounds like a metronome. We're talking with Paul Williams, who brought down this tape and was up there, and you can hear him singing. Will this be your first release?
You bet. I figured it'd start at the top, right?
Yeah, what are they doing there?
You can't join the Beatles, don't get into the business.
All right, now we've been talking with Paul Williams, and he's told us a lot of things that we like to know about. We also don't like to have people come down and talk to us on the radio and feel as if we've pumped them for information and said goodbye. What you are doing now, being no longer in a troupe called Crawdaddy and having given that up, is you're working down in Boston.
Not in Boston.
You're working with Avatar.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm with Avatar in California. But
there is a California Avatar.
No.
Oh.
I just live out there and support the magazine because it's about the best publication that's coming out of this country. And I'm a great supporter of Mel and Mel's trip. Like anybody who believes that you're God or that we're all God ought to recognize anybody who actually at this transitional point in the state of the world is willing to say he actually is God. Is very brave and taking on like a lot of karmic dues for all of us. Anybody who declares his own divinity, as Leary has and as Mel Lyman has, is making it a lot easier for the rest of us to function and should be supported wholeheartedly. It's not an ego trip, it's a world savior trip, and the world really needs saving. If you can also save the world, you should join in right away. But I'm surprised the amount of reaction against, you know, Mel's trip and that kind of thing that goes down. I think people don't really believe that we can do anything. We can do anything, and we're doing it, and if you get behind it, it'll expand it that much further. The trip about Mel's is open.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely open and right there. And Avatar is just a publication which reflects that spiritual energy, life energy, from Mel directly and from the people around him who are, you know, many of them very good writers and photographers and artists, and whose own energy is raised higher by having, by living within the community, by having, you know, Mel's strength at the center, and then their own strength radiates out further and gets people like me who are more out in the fringes, and I'm just trying to push it farther still.
Can you describe the sort of way in which a person can relate to, I guess, relate to Avatar, relate to Mel?
Well, like, if there's any question in your mind, just ask it. You know, like, if you got something to say, say it. And if you actually said anything, you'll probably get an answer. You know, there's no way to relate to any person. I mean, we're all people, and I can't tell you, like, what sort of thing to say to me, or how to get, you know, a response from me, or how to relate to me, because I don't know. You know, I'm a writer, so I can say, well, read what I'm writing. I would say, read what Mel Lyman has written, read his book, read the Avatar. You know, don't go up to Fort Hill and say, wow, where's Mel Lyman, what's going on up here? Because you don't want people to come into your living room and do that. You know, that's not, it's not a form of approach in which you're giving and getting. It's just kind of like being a voyeur. The thing to do is to approach the trip in a way that you feel comfortable. Like, at each level, whether if reading the paper makes you feel closer to the hill, then approach it at that rate. You know, at the point that you are a part of the family, you'll know it. There won't be any question. It may be that you don't belong in that family right now. In fact, I'm not living on Fort Hill myself. I live in a community in the woods on the ocean in California. But I still respect what's going on at Fort Hill. It's by far the strongest community I know of in this country, and certainly the highest spiritual energy in Boston. And I think it's improved the entire situation in Boston throughout the whole time that Fort Hill's been in operation, you know, through the Avatar paper and through just the general raising of the spirit. It's exactly like Leary's trip or Lennon's trip, in the sense that we have energy. We try to radiate it outward and share it with more people, as long as they're going in the same direction, which is, you know, straight up.
I see. Okay, I think I can begin to understand it.
Yeah, you know, I can just sort of feel your way. I'm not supposed to make sense. I'm just supposed to sort of push you.
Well, we thank you an awful lot for having come down here this afternoon, and we're also very interested in your book called Outlaw Blues.
Yeah.
Is that on the stands now?
It's in most places. They're not distributing it very well. The publisher treat me very nice, but they're not, you know, they can't put 1,000 copies in every newsstand because they're not that kind of people. But it's in, I've seen it in Harvard Square.
Mm-hmm.
It's around. I like it.
Well, we thank you an awful lot for having come down here and left a tape with us. We'd like to distribute that tape to other radio stations. If there are other people in the audience now who would like to run for the governor of California, we'll certainly give you equal time with Dr. Leary.
Fair enough. And Massachusetts, man, you know, don't let it slide away.
And we certainly hope that the California campaign will be a lot of fun.
Oh, it is.
Thank you.
This is Saturday afternoon. You're listening to WBCN in Boston.